For this is the day that the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. Come on, those of you that are in the building, can you worship the Lord with us? Those of that are streaming live, worship the Lord with us. For I was glad when he said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord and give him praise. Come on, come on, worship him. Anybody have the victory in the building? Anybody have the victory online? Come on, for the song says, victory is mine. I told Satan, get thee behind. Victory today is clap them hands. Out there in virtual land, you can put your hands together. Come on, say good morning to somebody. Hey. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today is mine. I told Satan, get thee behind. Victory today, it's mine. Everybody say,
victory is mine.
Whoa-ho.
Victory is
victory
mine.
Victory today.
Victory today is mine.
Oh, I told Satan.
I told Satan.
You better get behind.
Get thee behind.
Victory today.
Victory today is mine.
Oh, victory is mine.
Victory is
yeah.
mine.
Victory is,
victory is
victory
mine.
Victory today.
Victory today is
you better get behind.
Get thee behind.
Victory today.
Victory today is mine.
Oh, joy is mine.
Joy is mine.
Oh, joy is mine.
Joy is mine.
Joy today.
Joy today is mine.
Oh, I told Satan.
I told Satan.
You better get behind.
Get thee behind.
Oh,
joy today is mine.
Oh, joy is mine.
Joy is mine.
Joy today.
Joy today is mine.
Oh, I told Satan,
I told Satan,
you better get behind.
Get thee behind.
Joy today.
Joy today is mine.
Come on, put them hands together and give them glory. Hey, anybody want to claim it today? That's a good place to give him glory. Hey. Yeah. Oh, peace is mine.
Peace is
I
mine.
Know that peace,
peace
is, mine.
Is mine.
Peace today.
Peace today is mine.
Oh, I told Satan.
I told Satan.
You better get behind.
Get thee behind.
Peace today.
Peace today is mine.
Oh, peace is mine.
Peace is mine.
Peace
is mine. Peace
today.
Peace today is mine.
Oh, I told Satan.
I told Satan.
You better get behind.
Get thee behind.
I told Satan.
I told Satan.
You better get behind.
Get thee behind.
I told Satan.
I told Satan.
You better get behind.
Get thee behind.
I told Satan.
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 We don't have no joy.
I told Satan.
I told Satan.
I told Satan.
I claim my peace.
I told Satan.
I told Satan.
I told Satan.
I claim my joy.
I told Satan.
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 Get thee behind.
Get thee behind.
Victory.
Victory today is mine.
Yeah. Somebody make some noise all over this building. You got to claim the victory in your home. You got to claim the victory on your job. You got to claim the victory in your family. I told Satan, get thee behind. Everybody say,
victory today is mine.
Yeah.
Get thee behind.
Victory.
Victory today is mine.
Yes. Somebody ought to claim it right there. I feel that in my spirit. You got to claim it right there. Deliverance is yours. Joy is yours. Peace is yours. Victory is yours. I told Satan.
Satan.
Get thee behind.
Victory today is mine.
I got to claim that one more time for somebody else. If y'all don't mind, let me claim it for my daddy. Let me claim the victory for my dad.
I told Satan.
Get thee behind.
Victory today is mine.
Anybody know I'm a daddy's girl? So when daddy ain't feeling good, I told Satan.
Get thee behind.
Victory today is mine. That's what I had to tell the enemy. You gotta get out of here. Anybody tell the enemy, you gotta get out of here. One more time, say, I told Satan,
get thee behind.
Victory today
is mine.
Lord, have mercy. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. And don't anybody know you got the victory. You can tell the devil this means war. Tell him, I ain't going down. I'm sorry. I see you back there, sis. This means war, Joker. Everything God promised me. Oh, this means war. Yeah, we in this thing. Good soldiers in the army of the Lord. Come on, can you put your hands together right there, everybody? Come on. Listen, I've been the storm and the rain, but the blood remains the same. Whatever's going wrong, I got my war clothes on. I might be in a daze, but you can't have my praise. No matter the attack, I won't turn back. This means war.
Ooh,
yeah.
This means war.
Come on, can you declare it on the enemy? This means war.
This means war.
Come on, can I say that part again? Listen, I've been the storm and the rain, but the blood remains the same. Whatever's going wrong, I got my war clothes on. I might be in a daze, but you can't have my praise. No matter the attack, I won't turn back. This means war. Ooh, yeah. This means war.
This means war.
Come on, family, can we go right here? I plead the blood. Come on, I plead the blood.
This means war.
Put your hands on it.
This means war.
Yes.
This means war.
Anybody know you got gonna give up easy? You gonna fight for it.
This means war.
Listen, second verse goes like this. You can't have my family.
You can't have my
increase. You can't have my breakthrough.
You can't have my breakthrough.
You can't.
I plead the blood.
I plead the blood.
I plead the blood.
This means war. Oh, we bless your name, Jesus.
This means war.
Yeah. This means
war.
Hey, 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 hey. the verse for you. Listen, I got joy in my soul. God is in control. Got Satan on my trail, but I'm singing all is well. He's attacking every day, but I'm watching while I pray. No matter the attack, I won't turn back. This me.
This me, what?
This me.
This me, what?
Yeah. This means war.
This
means
war. This means war.
Come on, everybody, you can say it with us. I plead, I plead.
I plead the blood.
Come on. I plead the blood.
I plead the blood.
Over everything, over every situation, I plead.
I plead the blood.
Oh, yeah.
I plead the blood.
Kiss me.
Kiss me, war.
Come on, my brothers and sisters, let's wage war on the enemy. Tell the devil this means war. Amen. Joy in my soul. God is in control. Satan on my trail, but I'm saying all is well. Y'all didn't hear me. Satan on my trail, but I'm saying all is well. Amen. Just look at somebody and say, it is well with my soul. It is well with my soul. Hey, it's good to be in the house of prayer today. Amen. It's good to be amongst the living. Amen. It's good, amen, to celebrate, amen, the birth, the death, and the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Good to see all of you in the sanctuary. It's also good to see all of you on the stream. Amen. Listen, stream, don't log off when you find out what I'm preaching about. This is a very serious subject, a subject that many of us are dealing with. Amen. And the devil is really jacking us up because of this subject I'm going to preach today. Amen. So don't log off. Matter of fact, start sharing right now. Start sharing right now, because this is a word, amen, that can help every believer. Are y'all hearing me? Every believer. So we salute our deacons, our ministers, officers, and friends. Amen. Let's jump right into Bible country. Ephesians chapter 4, 32. Ephesians chapter 4, 32. Now, I'm going to tell you, I fly often. I'm going to tell you now to put on your seatbelt, because we're going to experience some turbulence. It ain't time to go to the bathroom, because when you're on the plane, when the plane is going through turbulence, they want you to sit down and buckle up. I don't need you walking on this one. I need you to sit down and buckle up. Ephesians 4, 3 and 2. Y'all ready? Here it goes. And be ye kind one to another, tenderhearted. This is where I'm going to lose you. Forgiving one another, even as God, for Christ's sake, have forgiven you. Sit down, buckle up, and enjoy the ride. Amen. I want to share with you, by way of subject, I want to talk about forgiveness. Uh-oh, and I lost you already. Forgiveness. Amen. Now, if you don't sit down and buckle up, if we hit an air pocket, you're going to hit your head. Amen. Somebody shout forgiveness. If you're in Streamland, somebody put that in the box, forgiveness. Brothers and sisters, I declared on December 31st, 2020, that the year 2021 will be the year of recovery. Y'all remember that? I declared and decreed that 2021 will be the year of recovery. I have to be responsible, and I have to be honest with you. You will never recover until you deal with your unforgiveness. God is not going to let you get back everything the devil stole from you if you're not operating in the spirit of forgiveness. Brothers and sisters, unforgiveness is a self-made prison. And here's the interesting thing about this self-made prison. You are the warden. You are the corrections officer. You have the power to release yourself out of a prison with no locks. But you chose to stay in prison because you choose not to forgive. Preach, black man. And so here you are in a prison with no locks, and you're the warden, and you are the correction officer. You are in total control, but you choose to stay where you are because you refuse to do what God has commanded us to do. Can I take my time? The Greek word for forgiveness, aphiomi. Aphiomi means, amen, I'm going to drop the charges. Aphiomi means, amen, even though you're wrong, I'm still going to drop the charges. Not because you're innocent, but because you're ignorant. I'm not releasing you because you're innocent. I'm releasing you because you're ignorant, because you don't know what and who you're messing with. Jesus said it best on the cross, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Some people don't know, don't have a clue who you are and whose you are. Can I get a witness in the building? So today, my brothers and sisters, I want to talk about what I believe is the most difficult thing for humans to do. Yeah, you remember the old cliche, Minister Washington, to err is human, to forgive is divine. To make a mistake is human. But to forgive, that's divine. I'm not talking about a simple excuse me type of forgiveness. Instead, I'm talking this morning about a real forgiveness that deals with the matters of the heart. The kind of forgiveness that prevents broken marriages, broken relationships, split churches, and prevent and heal all bitterness. Oh, y'all got quiet on me. Stay buckled down. God knows how hard it is to forgive. Did y'all hear what Pastor Thompson just said? God knows it's hard. I'm not here saying it's easy. God knows exactly how hard it is to forgive because he knows our hearts. He knows how to teach us to forgive because he's the author of forgiveness. Y'all got quiet on me. As we read our scripture verse this morning, I want to show you four truths. Just four truths. I want to show you the call to forgive, the complications with forgiving, the course to forgive, and the commitment for forgiving. The call to forgive. Somebody say the call. This is a command. Shall. Let's get this clear. To pardon, set aside completely a wrong done to you without payment, revenge, or punishment. Forgiveness is to pardon completely, to put the wrong aside without payment, revenge, or punishment. This is a command, I believe, because you cannot be spirit-filled Christian in the example of Jesus without learning and practicing forgiveness. I don't care how much you shout. I don't care how many backflips you do. How many cartwheels you do, you can foam at the mouth and speaking Yamaha, amen, and Tamaha, and y'all ain't helping me, Yokohama, amen. If you're not forgiving people, you don't have the spirit in you. You're manufacturing, amen, this thing called praise. You're manufacturing this thing called worship because you can't truly worship the God of forgiveness and have unforgiveness in your heart. That's an oxymoron. So we need to stop dancing and become disciples. You can shout, but are you a student of the word? Don't just be hearers of the word, but be doers of the word. Yeah. This command is not no. This thing is a spirit-filled Christian. God does not command it to be cruel or overbearing. He ain't trying to, amen, be mean and cruel. He is not the dictator. He's not a dictator forcing his evil demands on us. See what he says here. As God, for Christ's sake, has forgiven you. First of all, my brothers and sisters, he already forgave us, and he's not going to ask you to do anything he haven't already done. I couldn't follow somebody, amen, that tell me to do something and they're not even practicing. Y'all ain't helping me. I wouldn't sit on a pastor that tells you to forgive and he don't know how to forgive or she don't know how to forgive. I wouldn't sit under nobody that can't lead by example. And some of y'all think forgiving is softness. No, it ain't softness. It's spirit filled. Don't get it twisted, amen. Ain't nothing soft about your pastor, but I do have the Holy Ghost. And when I want to, y'all ain't helping me, get you the Holy Ghost, arrest me and say, don't get them, forgive them. Y'all got quiet now. That's right. Slow to anger. Swift to forgive. It cost Jesus his precious blood on the cross to forgive us. The nails did not hold him on the cross, but it was his love for us. Second of all, he is always at work in us to make us more like Jesus so that the world that needs forgiveness can see it tangibly. How you gonna say you're a Christian? How you gonna raise your children? How you going to be in a neighborhood? How you going to be on the job saying you go to church and saying you love the Lord, but they know everybody you hate? Because you're going to do it. You're going to tell people in your neighborhood who you don't like. You're going to tell people on the job who you don't like. And some of you have the mitigated gall to tell folk in the church who you don't like. But you want somebody to come to church with you. Stop telling them you go to New Harvest. You don't go here. Give them another church. Because they're going to say, what in the world is Pastor Thompson teaching if you're acting like this? Y'all quiet now. Don't we put on a seatbelt. We ain't even get started yet. We still going up. We have to show the world what God's forgiveness look like through us. Y'all done got quiet on me. Are y'all hearing me? I see you, Deacon Elliott, and Dirt, you here and you still online. I see you. I see you, Yolanda Davis. We got to show the world what forgiveness look like. The world ought to know what forgiveness look like when they look at us. They ought to know where to find forgiveness. Amen. It's bad if the world was searching for forgiveness. If they came in the church, would they find forgiveness even in God's house? Houston, we have a problem when the unbeliever is looking for forgiveness and church folk don't even know how to forgive one another. This truth is reiterated all through Ephesians chapter 4. Look at 4:29. Look at 29. Let not corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth, but that which is good to the use of edifying, that it may minister grace unto the hearers. Y'all don't like this kind of teaching. Amen. You can't, amen, do that from a place of bitterness. And forgiveness. You can't build nobody up if you're bitter. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Bitter people tear other folk down. Bitter people talk foolishness. Y'all quiet now. Yeah. Look what 5 verses 1-2 say clearly says we are to be imitations of his love, including his forgiveness. Be ye therefore followers of God. As dear children, chapter 5, Ephesians, it runs together, and walk in love as Christ also have loved us, walk in love, and have given himself for us an offering and a sacrifice to God for a sweet-smelling Savior. We talk love, but we don't walk love. Yeah. 5 and 18 give us the command to be spirit-filled. Y'all know y'all didn't want to. Yeah, this different today, ain't it? And be not drunk with wine, wherein is an excess, but be filled with the Spirit. Some of y'all filled with the wrong spirits. That's why you can't forgive. Okay. Y'all don't like me. Verse 21 says, submitting yourselves one to another in the fear of God. How do I biblically submit to someone without forgiving them? You can't. Because this is a command, there's a cost to disobedience. We're too emotional. We're emotional, we're stressed out, we're physically sick. Amen. And medical research has validated this. When you nurse a grudge, when you can't forgive, it ain't hurting the person that hurt you. You're hurting yourself. Y'all don't like me. There's spiritual consequences with no forgiveness. Watch this. Matthew 6:14. For if ye forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. Now, I'm not being funny when I say this. The only people that should not forgive are the ones that ain't doing nothing wrong. Uh-oh. Let that sit in your lap. Because guess what? Thank you, Reverend. If you ain't doing nothing, if you never did nothing wrong and never gonna do nothing wrong, ain't doing nothing wrong now, well, you don't have a problem. But if you did something wrong before and you're doing something wrong right now, and I got a sneaky suspicion you're going to do something wrong in the future, then you subscribe to forgiveness. Because when God forgave you for your past, your present, and your future, who do you think you are not to forgive somebody? Disobedience is sin. Somebody shout sin. We don't want to deal with that three little words. We like gin, but we don't want to deal with sin. Y'all quiet out there. I said sin, not gin. Sin interrupts our fellowship with God. He is serious about this issue. Thompson, he said, Thompson, how you going to preach they shall recover and you going to recover and everybody going to recover all and we ain't dealing with sin. We ain't dealing with forgiveness, because when we're dealing with unforgiveness, you ain't going to recover nothing. As serious, this thing is serious, y'all, because it's a major key to being the example of Jesus. Don't say you're a Christian and you don't want to be nothing like Christ. He called us to forgive. That's a call. That ain't a choice. That ain't when I feel like it. That ain't when I get around to it. Because if Jesus had to get around to forgiving us, Calvary would have never happened. He would have kept putting it off. Well, when I get around to it, God, I'm going to go down and save those. But the Bible said, while we were yet sinners, he died for us. Some of us only want to forgive when the person changed. Don't wait till they change. While we were still naughty by nature, he sent his very best to us. We want people to earn our forgiveness. Look at your neighbor and say, I don't have to earn your forgiveness. You either gonna forgive me or you're not. I don't have to jump through hoops and y'all do backflips. And I really want to say, I don't have to kiss you for you to forgive me. You're not my God. Amen. God forgave me. And if you don't forgive me, that's gonna be between you and God. That's the call. That's the call to forgive. But look at the complications with forgiveness. it's really hard, y'all. It's a problem. I mean, it's a problem. What is so hard? Why is it so hard to forgive? Forgiveness is the opposite. Can I tell you why it's so hard? Forgiveness. Now I'm gonna help you because some of y'all saying, well, he up there preaching that, you know, forgiveness stuff. But I'm gonna tell you why it's so hard. Forgiveness is the opposite of our human nature. I'm gonna say it. Listen, it goes against your nature. We don't naturally want to forgive. Our first response is war. It's revenge and retaliation. That's naturally a human first move. So it's unnatural to even want to forgive somebody that hurt us. That's why I got to be. That's why he asked us. I got you now. I got you. Y'all still got on y'all seatbelt? That's why he said in that verse 32, be tenderhearted. He asked us in the verse to be tenderhearted. This is not simply some sweet person who everybody likes. Instead, he's speaking of the condition of our heart and functioning with a Christ-like love. You can't forgive if your heart ain't tender. And I learned what a tenderizer was when mama, when I was growing up with mama, and when that meat was too tough, mama had to beat the you know what out that meat. And I said, Mom, what you doing? She said, I'm tenderizing the meat. And sometimes our hearts need tenderizing. And that's why God allows us to go through the vicissitudes of life, the pains of life, because he knows our hearts are hardened and we need to get beat up sometimes. Sometimes we need to go through the tenderizer. There's two people in the church, an egg and a potato. Are y'all hearing me? You either egg or potato, but one thing that changes the egg and the potato is hot water, baby. Hot water make an egg that's fragile tougher, and hot water make a tough potato softer. Can I get some witnesses in here? And sometime God has to put us through hot water to tenderize us. You wonder why you're going through what you're going through? Maybe your heart is too tough. Maybe you too hard. He need to soften your tail up. Yeah. We don't want to talk about sin. Sin hardens the heart. I say sin hardens our hearts. The result is to make us unable to forgive and love and do things as Jesus does. Sin will stop you from loving like Jesus. Sin will stop you from forgiving like Jesus. Sin will stop you from being compassionate. I feel a preaching anointing in this place. Amen. They sung the wrong song. I'm telling the devil right now, this means war. I will forgive. I will love like Christ. I will be compassionate like Christ because my life depends on it. Look at your neighbor and say, I ain't going to hell for nobody. No, really mean it. Really mean it. Amen. He that angers you controls you. Can I say it again? He that angers you controls you. Don't let nobody control you to the point where you're going to bust hell wide open. Okay, you don't believe me? Okay, I'm a Bible preacher. If you look at chapter 4, 17 and 19, sin made our hearts dark, lewd, and filled with greediness. Let's go to 17. Y'all don't mind being a Bible church, do you? 17 say, this I say therefore, and testify in the Lord, that ye henceforth walk not as other Gentiles walk, in the vanity of their mind, having the understanding darkened, being alienated from the life of God through the ignorance that's in them. Because of the blindness of their hearts. Y'all don't like Bible. It's the Bible. Look at 19. Who being past feeling have given themselves over unto lasciviousness, to work all uncleanness and greediness. Look what sin does. Look what sin does. It hardens our heart. It makes our heart dark, lewd, and filled with greediness. This is the deeply selfishness and rotten to the core picture of a sinner's heart. Lewd, lasciviousness, and greedy. How you gonna forgive when all that in your heart? Because in your mind, read it. I wish y'all read this when y'all get home. In your mind, you're right when you're dead, derriere wrong. That's how I can say that without cussing. You're dead, derriere wrong. But in your mind, the devil telling you right. Y'all can sit there and be all cute. The devil done told me in my mind I was right when I was wrong. Ignorance. Huh? Here it is. This was your pastor Hart at one time before he met Jesus. And guess what he did? He changed my heart. I ain't trying to get everybody back. I'm trying to win everybody to Jesus. Oh, y'all missed that. Don't you know, I'm finna put something in your lap. This may be a little too deep for you. Don't you know how you respond to people can win people for Christ? Don't you know it's hard for somebody to continue to be evil to you and you're being so good to them? But your ego is at play now. You're so stuck on your ego and your feelings that you don't care about winning anything for Christ. You want to win something for yourself. I wish I had a witness here. But when you deny yourself and show folk the love of Christ, you can win them. Amen. You can win them over. And they can tell somebody, I know that brother, I know that sister loved the Lord because I was a demon. I was an imp. Y'all ain't helping me. And they changed me by the way they dealt with me. Can I get a witness in the building? This ain't no little children Bible drill. This is a deeply important and significant adult-sized spiritual mission. Look at somebody say, I'm on a mission. If I'm going to recover all, I'm on a mission. I'm going to learn how to forgive folk. I'm going to learn how to let bygones be bygones. And I told you a long time ago, amen, forgetting has nothing to do with your memory. Forgetting means it does not affect me anymore. Okay. I'm losing. Y'all come back on live. Y'all don't come on. I got two more. The call to forgiveness, the complications with forgiveness. But look at the course of forgiveness. Somebody shout the course. Pastor, you preaching, but tell me how. I hear the call. I hear the complication. But if I'm going to do it, I need to know how. Somebody shout how. I'm glad you asked. Anytime God calls us to do something, he always tells us how. Y'all don't know when to shout. Here, he shows us. As God in Christ has also forgiven you. That's what we read. That's what we read. I'm still in the text. Thank God for a preacher that can stay in the text. And be ye kind one to another, tenderhearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake have forgiven you. That is how to do it, my brothers and sisters. It is to rely on God to show you through how he forgave all of us. This is important, and it will change your life. It's going to change somebody's life today if you apply it. Almost every time God teaches on forgiveness, he shows us a circular pattern. Here's God. Right back to God. He shows us a circular pattern. In other words, I forgave you. Bam. Consider that. Then you will implement the same forgiveness to forgive. Watch the verse. Bearing with one another and forgiving each other, whoever has a complaint against anyone, just as the Lord forgave you, so also you should forgive. Pattern. That was Colossians 3, 13. Write these scriptures down. I want y'all to read them when you get home. Colossians 3 and 13. It's a pattern. The how to lies in the pattern. I got some verses I want y'all to write down. Please write them down. You know, you ask me how, I'm going to show you how. 2 Corinthians 2, 8 through 10. Let me put my glasses on so y'all can hear it correctly. Wherefore I beseech you that ye would confirm your love towards him. Paul is talking. For to this end also did I write, that I might know the proof of you, whether ye be obedient in all things. Listen, to whom ye forgive anything, I forgive also. For if I forgive anything, to whom I forgave it, for your sake forgive I it in the person of Christ. Y'all got it? Matthew 6 and 12. Write it down. And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. How you going to be forgiven by Macy's and not want to forgive Marcus? Dylan let you go, but you won't let David go. Y'all don't like me today. Huh? J.C. Penney said we'll write it off, but you still holding on to Joseph. Okay. Luke 6 and 3, 7. Judge not, and ye shall be not judged. Condemn not, and ye shall not be condemned. Forgive, and ye shall be forgiven. That's scripture. It's ragu. It's like ragu is in there. Okay, I'm a word man. Mark 11, 25. Mark 11, and when you stand praying, forgive. If you have an ought against any, that your Father also, which is in heaven, may forgive you your trespasses. Pattern, bam, always back to God. How do I implement this pattern as a plan, as an action plan? I'm going to tell you how. We almost done. Y'all did good as students. Y'all stayed in your seats. Amen. We got the call to forgive, the complication with forgiving, the course of forgiveness. Now, here's the commitment for forgiveness. Here's how you implement it. First, I want you to do this every morning you get up. Review the scriptures I just gave you. Don't only review those scriptures, review any and every scripture that deals with forgiveness. If you got an app on your phone, you put in a search thing called forgiveness and read every scripture that deals with forgiveness. Look at yourself and consider your own sin. See, when I think about myself, everyone else suddenly seems in a different light. We look at everybody else but ourselves. When you look at yourself, you can see how wrong you have been and how wrong you have done. And then everybody else looks a little different. Because guess what? Your mind ain't telling you you're better than the person that hurt you. Because sometimes the person that hurt you is probably retaliating from the hurt they got from you. I'm going to sit there and let that marinate in your brain. Sometimes the folk that hurt us, we provoke them to hurt us because we consistently hurt them. And then when they hurt us, I never understood why people that lie get mad when lied on. This is what I'm saying. Now it's woe is me. You've been lying for years. Now you heard one lie on you and you can't handle it. But baby, what goes around comes around. Be not deceived. God is not mocked. Whatever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. Sometimes you have to look at yourself, because it's not the one that hurt you. Maybe your crops finally came back to haunt you. What you put in that ground is coming up again. That's why your pastor, listen to me very carefully. I don't always sow good seeds. I know I got some bad seeds in there, but just to hear, I'm going to help somebody. But I sow more good seeds than bad seeds, that when my harvest come, my good seeds overwhelm the bad seeds. But some of you only sow bad seeds, and every now and then sow a good seed and want to be patted on the back. But when harvest come, those bad seeds you have sown all through the years will choke out that little one good seed you sown. Somebody shout, look at yourself. Stop looking at everybody. When I review my own sins, when I review my stuff, tears come to mind. When I review me, I'm not looking at nobody else. When I realize that no matter how badly people have hurt me, I'm not bleeding on the cross like Jesus. When I realize how bad folk done hurt me and lied on me, I still wasn't nailed to a cross. I still wasn't whipped all night long. I still wasn't, amen, have a crown of thorn on my head. I still wasn't falsely accused. I still wasn't marched from courthouse to courthouse, from courthouse to courthouse. I still, amen, didn't come into my own, and my own, amen, did not receive me. I will never go through what he went through. No matter how bad it got for me on this side of the Jordan, what he went through tops it all. And he had the audacity to say, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Y'all wouldn't like this kind of preaching. First, we got to review the scriptures, right? And while we're reviewing the scriptures, that's what the Bible is. It's a mirror. Don't read the Bible and be thinking about who need to hear this. Don't come to church and sit and hear a word and say, ooh, I wish so-and-so was here to hear that. No, Negro, you here to hear it. And you got to put yourself in the mirror and see what God is saying to you. Because you're writing about who need to hear it, that means you're not hearing it. Yeah, review the scriptures and let that Bible be a mirror. Y'all ain't going to like this. Secondly, y'all writing it down? Review scriptures is one. This is the commitment to forgive. If you do this year, it's going to happen. Review scriptures. Secondly, be thankful for God's pardon for your sins. By thanking God for forgiving you of your sins, by thanking God for me forgiving my sin, I activate in my heart an understanding of forgiveness. Many of us don't understand forgiveness because we don't know we have been forgiven. Oh, y'all missed it. In order to understand forgiveness, you got to thank the one that forgave you. And I don't know about nobody else, but it does something to me to know God has forgiven me. Ooh, it softens my heart to deal with others. When I know God has forgiven me from every bad thing I've done on this side of the Jordan, amen, how could I not forgive somebody else when I'm thankful and grateful that he forgave me? I'm losing you. I'm losing you. Look at your neighbor and say, come back now. Come back. Come back. Come back. When we're authentically grateful for being pardoned, you'll know how to pardon somebody else. Thankful. Be thankful. Open your heart for God's supernatural work. Because of the praise and the surrender that is in there, he is now free to work in my heart to heal and create the faith for forgiveness. When I'm thankful, he comes in. He said, oh, he's appreciative that I forgive. It's bad when you forgive and the person ain't appreciative. Okay. I could put that back in the complications with forgiveness. Here you are, you forgave. Now, I'm not saying you expect them to kiss your you know what, but at least be grateful. And so if you feel like that, how you think God feel when we're not grateful? See, some of y'all come to church and you're still not grateful for what he did on Calvary. Some of you come to church for program. The churches have changed so much that it's more of a, we're not, let me walk tall when I say this. We're doing more performing. It ain't about a performance. We ain't coming to church to perform. We're coming to church to allow him to perfect. He wants to make us whole. But we're not praising him and worshiping him. We're performing. And there's a difference between performance and authentic worship. Look at somebody say, stop performing. Stop putting on show. Stop faking it, man. Live it. Live it for real. Okay. Y'all ready? First one is review scripture, right? Second is be thankful. Not y'all ain't gonna like this one. Third, ask God to reveal the sin in your heart. This process of forgiveness is critical. It creates in me an openness for God to reveal sin that is, here it is, hurting and hampering his work. Let me say it like this, because maybe I'm taking too long. You shouldn't preach with unforgiveness in your heart. You shouldn't teach with unforgiveness in your heart. You shouldn't usher with unforgiveness in your heart. You shouldn't be a deacon with unforgiveness in your heart. You shouldn't do nothing in this house if you got unforgiveness in your heart, because it's not authentic. And that's why you got to say, God, open up my heart and show me where I'm wrong. How you going to sing with unforgiveness? Who in the, oh man, who are you singing to if you're singing with unforgiveness in your heart? I got time, I'll wait. How you going to do ministry? Truly do ministry with unforgiveness? That's not even his style. That's why you got to ask God. Look at verse 31, same verse, same chapter. Chapter, see, I skipped 31 on purpose. Look at first, I got Bible. 4:31 say, let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. God is likely to reveal some things to us, to you, to I, that are uncomfortable. You don't come to church to be comfortable. When the preacher get up and preach, God ought to make you so uncomfortable that you want to change. You're not going to get it all back till you get out yourself. Oh, y'all got quiet now. Church ain't designed to make us comfortable. Church is designed to make us conform to his word and be committed to what he told us to do. And this is what baffles me. We want people to listen to us when we're not listening to him. Yes, oh, y'all got quiet now. Yes, you want everybody under your jurisdiction to follow you, and you ain't following nobody. And he said, let all bitterness, wrath. It's amazing. He put wrath and anger. Then he said, come on, that loud stuff. Be just being loud. And evil speaking, be put away from you with all malice. Then he goes into our verse, and be kind one to another. I done fooled you. Those verses connect. And be kind to one another, tenderhearted, forgiving one another, even as God, for Christ's sake, forgave you. God is likely to reveal some things y'all don't want him to reveal because it makes us uncomfortable. Again, rely on his forgiveness and work in our lives to heal and prepare us. Okay? I'm going to see if y'all right now. We got what? Review scriptures. Be thankful. Ask God to reveal the sin in your heart. Here it is. Ask God for faith to forgive. Once you repent, you can't do this without repenting. We do stuff wrong. We ask God to do stuff, and we have yet repented. And I'm going to say it again. You got to repent first if you're going to ask God to give you the faith to forgive. You know, you now are in tune with his forgiveness after you repent. And you know with confidence that as the author and finisher of your faith, he can do this. This also forces you to spiritually rely on him. We're not spiritual. We're carnal Christians. Can I say that one more again? We're not spiritual. We're carnal Christians. We want to display the Christ banner, but still keep our carnal ways. We're going to force God. We're going to force God to let us do it our way. And then have the audacity to say, God knows my heart, and he knows you're going to hell too. It ain't about God knowing your heart. Oh, y'all gonna like this. It's about you knowing God's heart. Ooh. Ooh. We want God to understand us, but we don't understand him at all. No, God, I was with you up until this. Review scriptures. Be thankful. Ask God to reveal sin in our heart. Ask God for the faith to forgive. And here it is right here. I got two more. And this one. Commit to set aside your feelings. Oh, man. This is. Yeah. Yeah. 2021, I'm getting my feelings out of it now. Do not go back and plead for God to do it again. God already done it for you. But you're messing it up because feelings. Nothing more but feelings. When you know God has accomplished it, emotions should be put aside. Emotions are still there because you didn't forget. Emotions will continue to open up the wound. You're too emotional. Don't be emotional, be spiritual. Turn to your scriptural foundation and stand on that and stop standing on your emotions. Emotions will make you, talking to some women now, maybe some men, because men acting like women these days. Emotions will make you bust the window out his car or her car. Emotions will make you cut up his leather seats with a razor blade. Or hers. Emotions will make you take all his clothes out the closet and pour bleach on them. Some of y'all done did some of this stuff. I'm going to find you in a minute. Emotions will make you, amen, show up to a job that you don't even work on. Just to make your point. Y'all don't like Pastor today. Emotions will have you do some crazy stuff. Emotions will have you hire private eyes. Set traps. Y'all ain't helping me. Emotions. And you don't stand on your emotions. You stand on scriptural foundation. Because when you're emotional, you'll never stop looking. When you're emotional, you can't give the benefit of the doubt. When you're emotional, all you in is, I'm going to catch this Negro one way or the other. Y'all quiet on me now. I done lost all the women. I done lost all the women in the house. Amen. Amen. I'm going to find out. I'm going to find out. I'm going to search his phone records. I'm going to find out. That's just too much work, my brothers and sisters. Especially when you ain't getting paid to do it. Take your emotions out of it. Here it is. Here's the therapeutic statement I'm going to make. Do not let the emotions rule you. Rule your emotions. Don't let emotions rule you. Stand on faith and on God's word. And guess what? God will take care of you and even protect you from folk that hurt you, because if you keep your mind stayed on him, he will give you peace. Perfect peace. But if you keep your mind on somebody else, you'll never have peace. You'll be up late at night. Can't sleep, baby. Can't eat, baby. Can't go on, baby, without you in my life. Seven whole days, not a word from you. Seven whole nights, and I'm just about through. Can't take it, won't take it. I had a look. I'd rather be on. Got it. You can do bad by yourself. Lights can go out. Y'all only helping me. FPL can turn on. I don't need a Negro with me to help the lights go out. I can do that by myself. Oh, 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 oh. Somebody say, get the emotions out of it. You're too emotional. Acting like Dre, Keisha. What you say, Kia? Huh? Too emotional. Now, women, don't get mad at your pastor, because I'm talking to the men now. Men have became more emotional than some women. And it's all the same foundation, because we're not standing on the promises of God. When you stand on God, you don't have to police a Negro. You put that Negro in God's hand and say, God, protect my mind, protect my heart. I'm gonna forgive him or her, but I'm gonna let it go. It looks like another love. Y'all know it. Do not let emotions rule you, because when emotions rule you, it will ruin you. Woo! You heard that, Reverend West? When emotions rule you, your emotions will ruin you. When your emotions rule you, your emotions will ruin you. Now, this is the last one's going to be real tough. Y'all got through. Review the scriptures. Y'all got through be thankful. Y'all got through ask God to reveal sin in your heart. Y'all got through ask God for faith to forgive. You got through commit to set aside feelings. But oh, this is the hard one. Y'all ready? Last but not least, pray for the other person. Uh-oh, it got quiet. Where y'all at? Oh, Facebook, I've lost about 10 people on Facebook. Pray. Oh, Anita Newkirk still with us. Gary Rutherford is still with us. Amen. Lily, thank you for hanging in there with me. Sandra, hang on in there. Kevin Teller, hang on in there. Here it is. Antrell, you here. Stop putting it on there. Amen. Amen. Pray for the other person. Somebody shout, pray for the other person. Oh, man. It's hard to still. Watch this now. Y'all going to like this. It's hard to still want to get somebody that you pray for every night. Somebody about to get set free in 2021. Put that joker on your prayer list. I ain't talking about this little phony stuff. I'm talking about really pray for them. And I ain't talking about pray that they come to their senses. Pray that they know what they did to me. I ain't talking about that. I'm talking about pray for their welfare. pray for prosperity, pray for healing, pray that God will make them, amen, better. Pray that, y'all ain't helping me, pray that they recover all in the year 2021, because the more you pray for them, the more it will release you from the prison that you put yourself in. Shout, pray for them. When you pray, when you can pray for God's best for them, then you are on your way to the road of recovery. When I can pray for the joker that hurt me, but pray for the, I ain't saying God get him. I'm saying God take care of him. God bless him. Matter of fact, God, before you bless me, bless them. God, I'm talking about enlarge their territory. God, do it. Do it. Do it, God. Do it, God. I know. See, God, I can only pray this prayer because I removed my emotions. Now I'm being spiritual. God, I want you to take them up, amen, to a higher level. God, I want them to be so blessed, amen, they'll turn around and bless somebody else. God, I'm praying for the best for them. Well, this ain't no hooping sermon, y'all. Bless them. When you can pray for God's best for them, then you are on the road to recovery. At Gethsemane, Jesus prayed for us. On the cross itself, Jesus spoke and prayed for us. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. He was still praying for us even when we was killing him. Well, hold up, Pastor. You went too far. I ain't killed Jesus. Yes, you did. Because your sins, my sins, our sins, our past sins, present sins, and future sins was on the cross of Calvary. Stephen, while being stoned, the first deacon for preaching the gospel, knelt down and cried out with a loud voice, Lord, do not charge them with this sin. When you pray, say, God, they did me wrong, but don't charge them. God, I'm telling you, God, don't do nothing wrong to them because they did me wrong. Oh, see, this too mature for y'all. Y'all better hurry up because I'll preach it again next Sunday. Better come on. God, I know they hurt me, but I don't want you to hurt them. Don't charge them, God. I pray. Let me tell you something. When somebody get on the phone with you that you know, that didn't happen to me, and you know they did wrong, Pastor, I pray for you. I pray your boy. I start trembling. That's some deep stuff, Pastor. I'm gonna pray for you, and they meant it. I pray your best. It's like that song that Whitney Houston remade. I will always love you. Listen to the lyrics of that. Listen to the lyrics. Y'all know the lyrics of that, huh? I wish you the best. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I wish you love. Uh-huh. And above all, some of us are not being honest with ourselves. Here's the honesty. Y'all ain't gonna like this. The reason why some of us can't forgive is because some of us are still in love. And I will always love you. And so it angers us to love somebody that did us wrong. How can I be so weak? Ooh. And so emotion sets in. And so instead of P-R-A-Y-I-E-N-G, come on, you know Pastor can't spell. Instead of P-R-A-Y-I-N-G, we're P-R-E-Y-I-N-G. I went to Ponciana. Rare say, that's all right, Pastor. Somebody say, don't do that. No, I love Ponciana Park. We were the Marching Cavaliers. Amen. You will know God is working in you and on you when you start praying for the one that injured you. That's exactly, Reverend. That's what Jesus did. When you start praying for people that injured you, you know he's working not only in you, but he's working on you. And I'm talking about when it's authentic. I got to go. I don't preach too long. But I think we took enough time for this, right? We this is something that we needed to learn today. The call to forgive, the complications with forgiveness, the course of forgiveness, but the commitment to forgive. We have to be committed to forgive. It's not going to happen. I just told you in the sermon, I'm not going to preach it over. It's unnatural to do this. So if it's unnatural, we got to commit to it. We got to review scriptures, be thankful, ask God to reveal sin in our heart, ask God for the faith to forgive, commit to setting aside our feelings. We too emotional. Always in our feelings. Keisha, do you love me?
This man.
Pray for the other person. Thank you for experiencing this flight. We're going to let you, the seatbelt lights are going to be turned off. You can now go to the restroom. And you can now, amen, move freely through the cabin. You're free to move about the cabin. May God bless you. May God keep you. Is our prayer. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you for forgiving us. And God, we thank you for working on us and in us. God, we thank you for those that hung in with us through this message, a message that's needed in the body of Christ. Bless us now. Teach me how to forgive. Show me my ways. I'm tired of looking at everybody else's ways. Show me my ways. And God, if someone was listening to this message and they don't know you in the pardon of their sins, we pray now that you forgive them of their sins. They confess with their mouth and believe in their heart that you are the Son of God and you died and was raised with all power in your hand from the grave, that they are saved. We thank you. We exalt you. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Listen, viewers and those in the sanctuary, if you're going to recover all this year, we got to deal with this prison called unforgiveness. Follow the instructions that was laid out to you this morning and watch what God do in 2021. Listen, you don't have to be in the sanctuary to connect with this ministry. You can do this right online. Just type in, amen, your information. I will find you on Facebook, and I will take you in to be a part of this ministry. Now, I need you to do one last favor. I don't beg, but I'm asking you to share this. Share this with people in your family. Share this with your Facebook friends. Share it, because this world, I believe, will be a better place if we forgave one another. If we had this spirit in us, they wouldn't have never stormed the Capitol. Amen. They'd have been too busy looking at themselves. Amen. This breeds hatred. This breeds division. Unforgiveness breeds retaliation. That's all that was at the Capitol. Retaliation and revenge, because somebody lost. And we don't like to lose. But how many know you'll never lose with Jesus? I wish I had somebody. You'll never lose. Amen. You'll never lose. You'll never lose. You'll never lose. Matter of fact, amen, to live is Christ and to die is gain. Take us out, praise team.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. From the bottom of my heart to the depths of my soul. Yes, Lord. Completely, yes. My soul says yes. Everybody say,
yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
From the bottom
of my heart
to the depths of my soul. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
says yes.
Anybody wanna say I love you?
I love you.
Almighty God, I love you.
From the bottom of my heart
to the depths of my soul.
I love you.
I really do.
Yes, Lord.
From the bottom of my heart
to the depths of my soul.
Yes, Lord.
To the depths of my soul.
I love you.
I love you.